The first part of my video had to be done on transferring a patient from a stretcher to a bed. The first thing that you need to do before handling a patient and doing anything with them is to perform hand hygiene. And then the next important thing to do is to identify your patient, just to make sure that you're not transferring the wrong patient somewhere. When the patient is ready to transfer from the stretcher to the bed, make sure that there is a friction reducing sheet underneath them. A transfer board can also be used. It's important to make sure that the wheels on both the stretcher and the bed are locked before transferring the patient, just to make sure that the bed or the stretcher don't move when the patient is moving. Ideally, this would be done with three nurses, if there's three people available to do it. If not, you find ways to work around it. But if you did have three nurses, you would have two people on the side of the bed who are going to be pulling, and then one person on the side of the stretcher who would be pushing. When it does come time to move the patient from the stretcher to the bed, the nurses will count to three and they will all pull at once, just to make sure the patient is being moved at one time and is comfortable. After the patient is moved onto the bed, make sure that they get covered back up and that you raise the bed rails up and then lower the bed to a comfortable height and make sure that the patient is comfortable. The second thing that I had to do was transferring a patient from the bed to a wheelchair. Again, make sure that when you're coming into the room, you perform hand hygiene and identify your patient. To begin doing this, you'll place the bed in the lowest position if it isn't already there, and lower any bed rails that need to be lowered. We'll make sure that the bed's wheels are locked as well as the wheelchair, and that's very important. To get the patient up, you'll just get them to sit up and put their legs on the side of the bed. Let them dangle their legs over the side of the bed for just a few seconds just to make sure that they're not dizzy. You can either lift this patient with or without a gait belt. If one is available, it's nice to use. But with or without it, you would get the patient to put their hands on your shoulders, and you would wrap around their waist. And to pick them up, we would do a little rocking motion together. And on the third rocking motion, we would lift up. The nurse is going to lift with her legs and not her back, just to be safe. And once the patient is up, just let them kind of stand there. And then we would pivot them into the wheelchair. After that, as they are going down into the wheelchair, though, we would try to get them to help us if they can by like just bracing themselves. But after that, it's important to make sure that they are covered on their back, and nothing is like showing or anything, and that they're comfortable and that they're ready to go, and all of the call bells and stuff are in reach for them, so that they feel safe. And that's going to be all.